I do want to welcome in someone who joins us every Friday to kind of return us to, you know, fun activities during all of this. He's Michael Snyder, everyone.
Hey, hi, guys.
Hey, Michael.
I'm so excited, but now that I've learned about glow-in-the-dark toilet paper, I'm stocking up for Halloween.
That's how long it's going to take you to get it.
That house up the block is going to look so lovely at midnight after I paper it. Listen,
after
guys,
you do your
seriously,
work.
I want to get serious about it. I got a pandemic fashion tip for you. I've been wearing my bandana wherever I go, whenever I go out, and I've learned something really cool. If you pair your bandana with a cowboy hat, you can get all your groceries for free.
There is a weird thing.
Don't say anything. Hand them your shopping list and just glare at them. And I swear to God, it works.
That and a ski mask.
It is true, though. You know, I was walking yesterday, and more people are wearing the bandanas and then covering up in other ways, too. And it does have a kind of weird. You realize how we react to people's eyes and faces so much. And I always wave and smile. And soon when I'm wearing the bandana or whatever, you won't see the smile. I guess you just have to do the wave, you know.
Really? Just do the wave. Actually, don't do the wave at Pac Bell Park, but everywhere else it's perfectly fine.
You can do
right
it.
Now.
This has to be a tough day for you. This would be Giants opening day, wouldn't it?
Exactly. Thank you. That's why I brought up the venerable park by 3rd Street. And, of course, I continue to call it like the traditionalist I am, its original name, Pacific Bell Park, much lovelier than the tiresome Oracle, AT&T, whatever else it's been since then. And I miss the stuff terribly. We're housebound. I'm trying to make the best of it. For instance, my lead column in the Marina Times this month is all about vintage comedies that'll get your mind off this stuff. Things you can stream online, classics like the Monty Python stuff, some like It Hot, some old Preston Sturges films, but some movies that are really worth revisiting to kind of cheer yourself up a little bit, you know?
And so where can you see some of the older stuff? Like that's not on Netflix, is it?
Some of it is. Some of it's on Amazon Prime. You can find things. Maybe TCM has a link or so. You can certainly purchase some of these classic movies. I know a lot of the Preston Sturges stuff is in the Criterion Collection, and it's much less expensive than going out to the movies. You can sit down, even if you're renting some of the movies that have been debuting on streaming video, you're paying less for the whole family or for your own self to sit there and watch a film than you would if you had to go out and buy the popcorn, the whole drill.
No, you're right. Popcorn. You're right. I mean, it's saving us money. That's the good news. The bad news is that, many of us are losing jobs and all the rest. So it's kind of like there is no money. But yeah, I mean, it's a price to pay. But I hear you. I mean, that is the side of staying in. I was trying to see The Taking of Pelham 1-2-3, the original, last night.
Right.
I was trying to see it last night. Walter Matthau and is Martin Balsam, I think, is in it too, and sure. Robert Shaw. It's a really good movie, and it was on TCM, but I couldn't get them because I don't have the right account thing or whatever. But those, it can. So you kind of have to plan because it was going on, and like I was trying to see it in real time, and you kind of have to make a plan.
Use your algorithms, people, number one. Number two, get out there and do a little research. Hey, incidentally, if you want a free ride, HBO, and I guess at HBO.com, is starting a free movie and TV show routine where you can just watch some classic HBO TV programs, catch up to them, watch some Warner Brothers movies, all for free. And Focus Features has free streaming movies on Mondays now at the company's Facebook page. A select group of their, top-notch, I guess we call them indie films and some foreign stuff. And, can't be beat. The price is right, as they say.
Oh, yeah. That's great. That's really cool.
Well, that's HBO's way of trying to hook you in, right? Give you a little candy.
Yeah, it's the CBS All Access trick. Hey, watch Star Trek Picard and then hang out. Yeah.
Get you hooked.
You come for the Star Trek and you stay for The Good Wife or whatever happens.
That's right.
Also be there. So there are a few new I'm sorry, go ahead, buddy.
No. That's exactly what I wanted. So that's cool. I mean, those are cool free rides in effect. And yes. What else can we find?
Okay, so new movies that are coming. Well, you know, we were talking about the Jesse Eisenberg film Resistance last week, where he plays Marcel Marceau during World War II, helping orphan kids out of Nazi-occupied France. He's also the star, along with the young British actress Imogene Poots, of a pretty cool and twisted movie that I alluded to last week, Vivarium. It is simultaneously kind of nifty and depressing, and it mixes sci-fi and horror and absurdist themes in a very mundane setting, which is this as-yet unpopulated suburban housing development where all the homes appear identical. The young couple is looking to buy a starter home, and a real estate agent takes them there. And they're not real crazy about what they see, this prefab cookie-cutter situation, and they try to drive back to the city and can't find their way out of the development. They are trapped.
Oh, wow, that's great!
Okay, so, you know, paging Jean-Paul Sartre, you know, the guy who wrote No Exit, I'm telling you, Vivarium is kind of a nightmare scenario, especially now when all of us are stuck in our own neighborhoods. It's probably the right movie.
Is it a horror film, though, Michael, or what is it? Psychological thriller? What is it?
It's a mix of sci-fi and thriller and a little bit of horror because, you know, it's creepy. It's very creepy, but in the best possible way. Directed by someone named Lorcan Finnegan, written by Garrett Shanley, and starring Eisenberg and Poots. And they're very good in this thing. And, you know, I dug it. All right. Something a little more twisted. Yes, a little more twisted than that. Swallow. At the same time, something very, very, you know, familiar in some ways. It's led by this incredibly fine-tuned performance by young actress Haley Bennett, who I haven't seen in movies for a bit. She's been a little missing in action, but she's wonderful in what is a disturbing, desperate housewife-type drama with a medical twist. The young heroine of this thing, played by Haley Bennett, pretty, recently married, handsome, up-and-coming businessman husband. She seems to have it all, expansive new house, but there's nothing for her to do in this, like, mink-lined prison but cook and clean and wait for hubby to come home so I guess they can potentially procreate. So she privately starts compulsively swallowing things. I know, it's strange. It's a real disorder. It's a real disorder called pica, and it sounds like, you know, the clarion call to a Pokemon on pica, 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 but no, this is no fun. I mean, you won't find me trying to catch them all anyway, but this is a bizarre but real true subject. It's not a true story, but it kind of takes off from this actual medical syndrome, and it's smart and really compelling. It's feminist filmmaking in a lot of ways, but because you start seeing the underlying pressures she has to live up to a certain standard, and you know, you'll be shuddering and thinking, uh-oh, what's she gonna swallow next?
Oh my God, what a bizarre subject for a film. But, I mean, as you say, it's a real disorder. I mean, I wasn't aware of it, but man. So I ask you on this one, is this a horror movie or is this just a drama?
Well, think about this. A woman trapped in a mink-lined prison. I mean, think about this for a second. Both of these movies play out to some really topical circumstances and fears. Okay. All right. I got one.
We only have a second or two left. Finish strong.
Okay, Blow the Man Down is this really cool noirish crime comedy set in a small fishing village on the Rocky main coast, and two sisters are burying their mom in time to take on the family store. One will do so, one wants to get out of town, but something awful happens when the latter goes out to get drunk and meets this creepy guy, and there's a big cover-up, and then you find out that the matriarchs of this town know all of these secrets and have a relationship to the mother, and the town madam, who's also caught up in this, you know, every small town has a boudoir, Margot Martindale, who is absolutely great. I thought this was sneaky, funny, really done by a two-woman team of Danielle Crotty and Bridget Savage Cole, and Blow the Man Down was really diverting. I think it's ideal to while away a weekend evening.
Wow. Blow the Man Down, Vivarium, and Swallow. And then all that free stuff that Michael told you about. Michael, I wish we had more time. I'm sorry, we got to wrap up, but we so appreciate you visiting with us every week. And we'll see you next Friday, pal.
Yes, have a good week, sir. Mark.
All right. Pat's next, and we'll try to mop up what we can in the last few seconds. Mark Thompson, KGO, 810.